Hello, I'm Mr. Armiger, and I'm a lecturer in metallurgy, and I preach Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia-free. Here I want to tell you that God is known by His grace, and He is known through logo, and logo is the product of logical reasoning. If you are capable of logical reasoning, then only God is known to you, and you know the God, and God knows you. It is a personal relationship between man and God, between the person and the God, personal relationship. In Christ Jesus, you have to be first Son of God, and in Christ Jesus, our soul is concerned, not our physical body. So once you realize that you have a supernatural Father of our soul, which is supernatural, and then you become twice born, and then you hate none. You love all. You exercise love called agape. Because when a person is born, whether he is born in India, in England, or in Africa, or white, or brown, or whatever color he is, it is not his choice that he was born there. It was God who sent the soul in him, in that country, or in that person. So, then you will realize that we have one Father. You don't hate people on the basis of their color, skin, color of the skin, or the origin where from come from. India, Pakistan, wherever they come from. So you love all under agape, unconditional divine love as exercised by the Salvation Army people. They are nearest to God. Church of England people are nearest to Satan. They glorify soldiers who killed people who looked at them. And when they died, they say they glorified God. So their God is not the one which is loving and merciful, but Mammon, a killer. So they are anti-Christ. And you can see in Britain, that's why so much racism and hatred is there, that so much crook over here, that it become a country of fraud. So here is the introduction to the first, you know, this is the rabbis where you teach the moral laws. Up to the age of say 15, 16 or 20, you have learned the scripture, which is milk. Milk. Then you want to know why it is written so. What is the root of the word, like Allah? People say, some people don't know why Allah is called Allah. If you ask these Mohammedans why Allah is called Allah, I hope there is none of them will be knowing that one. Very few one. And that is what it is, you know, the people who are pondering over it, are seeking, they will know God, not those who are not seeking. So you must have a longing for God, as Saul had longing for God. He was a strictly blind under the blind guide Gamaliel. But when Jesus opened his eyes, because he had the longing for God, sincere, then he came to know the gospel truth, which is known by the grace of our supernatural Father. Nobody can give you. God lives in his house, which is this one, temple of God, not created by human hand, but by the greatest artist, Demiurge Potter, Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, same thing, demiurge. They are the potters. The soul inside me is of Allah, Parbrahm, and Elohim. Allah is called Allah because it is from Illah. Illah is my, this tribal father. My tribal father is Jat. Jat is my tribe. Some are Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe. So first you have to be son of your tribal father. So if you have the common sense or the, we call it Surti, of your physical father, secular father, then only you know the spiritual father, which is Al-Illah, the father, spiritual. He is the father of our soul. So here is the relationship between John the Baptist and Christ Jesus. Because in Jerusalem or in Israel, people had become Jew outwardly. When they became Jew outwardly, they can't build their covenant with Abraham. Because if Abraham was a Jew outwardly, then the people of Ishmael should be Jew as well. Jew is a spiritual self inwardly. That as St. Paul has clearly stated in the Bible, a Jew is one who is inwardly, spiritual, not outwardly, physical. So not a single Jew died. People are Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, led by their blind guide. They fell into the pit of Holocaust. So you can't blame a third person. They became unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, and they suffered. So here is the relationship between John the Baptist. John the Baptist is here a prophet. Prophets are angels. They worship Yahweh, demiurge. Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, Brahman, and all these come here, you know, moral teachers. Matthew 13 verse 52 is defining a moral teacher. And here he teaches them the moral of Moses and discipline them. That is why they have disciples. So that tribal seed is to be sown here, the ego of the tribal seed. Like, don't, that's why St. Paul said, don't put your tribal seed on mental peace and keep on praising, my father was so and so, so and so. He was a big man, he was very rich, this and that. Put that seed into the soil. When you put it into the soil, then the seed disappears, a plant comes out of it. The identity of the seed then becomes implicit in the plant and not explicit anymore in seed. So then you become a spiritual person explicit. Then you become the son of the Most High, Allah, Parbrahm, Elohim. And then you enter this one, which is the fold of God, royal kingdom of God. Here we have one father, we are all his sons, because soul represents our father. So there is no daughter here or woman here, because the woman has no identity on marriage, you know, their surname changes. So they have no identity, only the men have the identity. That's why in 12 laborers of Jesus, they were all men, not a woman included in that one. Because it was a combination of seven of Nanora of flesh, which John the Baptist was doing, in that he prepared 70 outer circle laborers and 5 of heart, temptations of heart, which are to be overpowered by his word. His word is a flux, for our heart, which cleanses out the impurities. So here you are, this is the royal kingdom of God, and here you are solitary. So that is why God, you know the God, and God knows you on solitary basis. And so when you preach gospel, don't worry what people say. Say what God inside you teaches you, what pleases Him, you say from your mouth, not what pleases the public. That's what the politicians do. They speak things that please the public. And they turn their back to God. Like Tony Blair and Bush said, that Saddam Hussein had weapons of mass destruction. There were none at all. So it was a white lie from the core of their heart, which is called blasphemy. And blasphemy is not forgivable. So that's why Putin is going to sort them up now. America and the West that destroyed Iraq, Libya, other things, did the satanic work, this work of the Satan. Putin, a man of God, because he has the tribal identity. Most tribal people are in Russia. And the tribal people have the right to survive. 144,000, they are all mentioned by the tribes, not as Jews. So they have the right to inherit the earth. So they are the winner. So atomic quad seed will be laid on 14 May 2023 when Israel might attack Iran. If it does so, then after 6 months will be atomic war. Menorah, remember the candles of menorah, 6 are of secular, of Yahweh. The 7th middle candle is of Elohim, Allah, Pabram. And here it is. So, these 6 candles, 3 here and 3, we perform secular works. This is works. And by the grace you know the middle candle, which is of God, Elohim Allah Pabram. In honor of Christ Jesus, this is raised above the other 6, that Christ has come. These Messianic Jews, they are the one, remember in the last parable of wine press, when Jesus said that these husbandmen are no good for any other job than job of a priest. So they enter the church of God with written Torah, which is forbidden, Jewish level, and started teaching the, reading the Old Testament and bringing in their customers back to the churches as they were in the temple. And they were the one who loved light, who loved darkness, as the temple priest loved darkness. So they loved darkness too, and they start killing the apostles by throwing them before the animals to be eaten alive. So Hazrat Muhammad Sahib of Ishmael, man of salt, he could not tolerate that one, so he organized the force to deal with them. First he was so furious that he told his people that wherever you see a Jew, kill him. But as they were humble and they were clever, so they entered the fold of Hazrat Muhammad and bring in all the temple practices there. Kosher is halal, circumcision, which is tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Only the people of Isaac can have circumcision, nobody else. Much more I have told in my other videos if you are interested. So here I want to tell you that God is known by grace to a person, whether in flesh, the person is a male or female, Jew or Gentile, that doesn't matter, because our soul is concerned. So unless you are a son of God, that you know God and you become His son and you preach gospel by eating the flesh of Jesus, what came out of the mouth of Jesus, pondering over your heart than preaching the logo from your own mouth logically. As I said, a Jew is the one who is a spiritual self, not physical. Not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. And you say so in a church and see how people will jump at you. So, on an individual basis, it's known, and God is within here. He is not in heaven alienated. So those people who say prayer, our Father in heaven, they are spiritually blind people. That's why St. Thomas said Christianity or Christ is known to 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. So when you have God inside you, you become His spokesman. You are not a Christian, but Christ. And your covenant with God is a Holy Spirit, which is common sense. That's why good news was broken to the shepherd and not to the university professors in Jerusalem. So these university professors, you see them in the universities and colleges, they are super donkeys carrying holy books. They have no knowledge of the gospel, because to know gospel, you need to be solitary and enter into the fold of our supernatural Father. So you can't take the whole class into that one. So that's why we teach the dead letters in the universities and colleges, with no knowledge of the oral Torah or His Word, which is the taproot of the scripture. So this is the taproot of the scripture relationship. So the Matthew 13 verse 24, this is the scripture. Up there you can see, but this top root you have to perceive. That is what Jesus said, they see, but not perceive. This top root that Jesus came to deliver, this is the light of Christ. So Moses put on Christ and he wrote the written Torah. That was good. But these people in the Jerusalem, they corrupted it. The written one. The old cloth full of holes. This is brand new cloth, untouched by human hand. You receive direct from God and not from any man. So that's why St. Paul said, listen to everyone and vet them in Holy Spirit, which is common sense. So shepherds, imitate people will get gospel, because they are new skin, and not these people full of the old wine. The people full of old wine, they desire it not the new. They say the old is good in debate and other things, something Bible, something Quran, something that one book. That is what the strictly blind people do, because in God, Bible is forbidden. That's why Jesus said, take no money in your pocket. No two shoes, no two tunic, and no script. Script means Bible is forbidden there. Because our covenant with God is the Holy Spirit and not of the dead letters. So many people, they understand it, but they dare not open their mouth. If you don't open your mouth, this knowledge will kill you, because people, there are so many things happening in the world. If you don't speak the gospel truth, which is your armor, then the armor is inside you, but you are not using it, and you will be armorless fanatic like the other people, and other people don't know your value unless you speak and preach and tell the people around you. Preach gospel. And that was called love for agape. And no more killing or anything. And my father had 2,000 people came to attack our village in India during partition 1947. And my father had this knowledge. So, unfortunately, headman of the attacking party knew my uncle. So he sent for my uncle to come out and explain why we have people in our village. So my father went with him, and when he told the attacking headman that we tribal people are going to be, tribal people are born, tribal people will die. People are Judah tribe, Levi tribe, Benjamin tribe, they led by their blind guide. They died, not a single Jew died. Same way my father told them that not a single Sikh or Muslim can die because they are never born. Tribal people are born, tribal people die. If you want to fight with us, we are tribal people going to fight with each other and kill each other. If we have any enmity against us, let us fight. He understood it. He said, no, no, we are friends. And he told the 2,000 people to look after us as their guest, which they did, and gave us the full protection. So that is the gospel can do. The armor, if you put it on and use it, then it will save you. But if you, that St. Thomas has said, if you know this gospel truth, and you hide it in your heart, and don't preach it from your mouth, then it will kill you. It's good for nothing. You have been given the treasures of our supernatural Father, and you are hiding it, not multiplying it. And the firstborn people who were given one talent, he put it under the, put it, hide it, and he did not use it. So you will be like that person. The one who was given five, the full knowledge, as the Samaritan woman had. She multiplied it, and she became, the whole village became apostle. And these men of that letter, they call her, she was a prostitute, marrying one husband after the other. As Nicodemus said, shall I go back into the womb of my mother to be born again? So that is what he did in letter. People will speak about gospel or the Bible. The Bible is forbidden in there, up in the royal kingdom of God, because you yourself become Christ. That's why St. Thomas went to India. He was known as Christ Thomas, and the people of his brethren, they were all known Christ, because they could teach gospel from their mouth, not looking at the Bible or anything. So if you take Bible out of the hand of a person and ask him a question and see if he can answer it, or he will take the Bible, open the Bible and answer you one point, then he will cross-reference. He will go to that one, answer it, then cross-reference, make you fed up. That person knows nothing. That's why Bible is forbidden. Bible, gospel gets written over your heart through logical reasoning. And from heart you preach gospel. In Christ Jesus, what comes of your own mouth, that matters. Not what is this professor said, that professor said. What this holy book said, that holy book said, that matters nothing. So be Christ in the name of Christ Jesus, and preach gospel from your own mouth, from the rooftop. Make t-shirt or other things. Put light on the living lampstand. Those people who are interested, they will knock on your shoulder and ask you. Don't throw pearls before swine. As the two men in graduate were doing, they were ended up locked in the silence of the graveyard. And the heavy chains were broken by the Holy Spirit. And those stupid people could not understand that we put the heavy chains and how they get broken. And that's why Christ Jesus went there and taught them a good lesson by drowning 2,000 swine into the lake. And that is what happened to you if you don't care to listen to Christ Jesus and preach gospel from your own mouth. As the sons of the Most High called Christ, not Christians of the book. Christians are people of the book as you know it. But Christ are not, Christ are of spirit. Our Father God blesses you in agape, unconditional divine love.